update you on who could be heading to the Lone Star State to compete at the Rogue Invitational. That's next on Game Central. Hi, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Game Central presented by Guaranteed Rate, the official mortgage company of the Noble CrossFit Games. Just because we are in the offseason does not mean that there is a shortage of competitions going on right now. Rich Froning, Tyler Christoffel, Bailey Rail, and Paige Powers headed overseas to Sardinia, Italy, take part in the WAD War for Mori, a CrossFit licensed event. And it was no surprise that they brought home the competition win. CrossFit Mayhem scored a total of 7,335 points to take the top spot on the leaderboard. Mamma Mia was second, and Team On Air took third with 4,969 points. Now, this is the first time that Rich Froning has competed with a Mayhem team in Europe. Now, he has competed in the past there as part of the CrossFit Invitational squad. He was a member of the U.S. team in 2013 in Berlin, and again in Madrid in 2015. And speaking of invitationals, the Rogue Invitational is the next big CrossFit competition on the calendar. It takes place in late October at Del Diamond in Round Rock, Texas, just outside of Austin. And for the second straight year, there will not only be a CrossFit competition, but there will also be a strongman competition taking place at the same time. And the online qualifier for that event was held recently. And for more on who could be heading to the Lone Star State, here's Tommy Marquez.
Thanks, Sean. The Rogue Invitational Qualifier, dubbed the Q, gave athletes four tests to compete for five guaranteed spots at the finals in October. And now that the leaderboard has settled, we have our 10 total qualifiers. And it's an eclectic mix of individual games athletes, team podium finishers, and even some CrossFit Games champions from the teenage divisions. So we're going to start on the women's side, and Manon Nganez, the former national champion of Belgium, takes home the top spot. Manon finished all four events in seventh or better to beat out Olivia Kerstetter by just 1 point. The 16-year-old Kerstetter is just over a month removed from winning the 16-17 division at the CrossFit Games, and will now have a chance to make her individual division debut at Rogue. Joining them will be Norway's Andrea Solberg, Annika Greer of Canada, and New Zealand's Bailey Rogers. Solberg finished 27th at the 2020 Games after earning her spot through the Filthy 150 that year. Greer, an up-and-comer in this sport, was a Games hopeful this season before her year was cut short after a score submission mishap. And Rogers is a former Games team competitor back in 2017 before competing at semifinals the last two seasons as an individual, finishing 6th and 7th respectively. Over on the men's side, Chandler Smith is on a redemption tour after his season ended at semifinals when he battled through a medical issue. He wins two of the four Q events to earn his way back to the same event that he finished fifth at in 2019, earning his first career trip to the CrossFit Games that season as well. Fresh off a podium finish in the Affiliate Cup with CrossFit Invictus at this year's Games, Jorge Fernandez is throwing his hat in the individual ring in a big way. He finishes tied in points with Chandler to secure his spot in Austin, Texas, never finishing lower than fourth in any event to hold down second place overall. Scott Tetlow, Jack Farlow, and Tim Paulson are the other three men that will be joining them from the queue. Tetlow finished 17th at the 2020 CrossFit Games and finished 11th each of the past 2 years at semifinals. Barlow, a 20-year-old former Games teenage division competitor from Canada, turned some heads at the Atlas Games this year with the third heaviest lift of any athlete in the semifinal barbell complex. And Paulson now gets his first crack at the Rogue Invitational after six straight appearances at the CrossFit Games and finishing 23rd this year in Madison. So a good mix of veterans and newcomers making it out of the queue, Sean, and some athletes that could certainly shake things up once we get to Texas.
We'll be right back. amazing aesthetics.
Thank you.